Hello, Etienne Blouin here for ABICOR BINZEL. Today the topic is how to test your fume extraction system. So why would you need to test your smoke extraction system? Well, if you've been into smoke extraction with a MIG torch already, you know that the effectiveness of your extraction is highly related to the vacuum system you're using or how it's behaving. In a vacuum system, there are two parameters that are the most important to follow. One is the flow, the other one is the vacuum pressure. Because vacuum pressure and flow are directly related and are always going to be linked to one another, there's only one reading that you need to make in a plant in order to understand what your vacuum system is doing. For any set static pressure of the vacuum system, you get a flow through the torch. The torch is a restrictive tool and the air goes through, but if you have a set pressure at the inlet, you will always have the same flow going through the torch. So really, the only reading that you need to make is the static pressure at the entry of the torch. Because the torch is always the same, all you need to know is what inlet pressure you get at the elbow of the torch to figure out your flow. I'll show you how to connect a simple device and read the pressure coming in order to figure out the flow. Your torch is connected to your welding machine here at the back end of the torch. And what you want to do is, at the inlet connection of the vacuum hose, you disconnect there and you add your simple pressure reading device. So now you have an inline reading of the vacuum pressure that goes right into your torch. Once the device is connected to the vacuum system, you can do your reading right there. So basically, you will see a reading that is a static pressure in the vacuum. In America, we mostly see inches of water as a reading. In the rest of the world, in the metric system, you'd see kPa or millimeter of water. So how much static pressure do you need to perform good smoke extraction with a MIG torch? There's no simple answer to that. If you're welding at low parameters, you don't need as much vacuum and static pressure to do a good smoke extraction. If you're welding with a big wire with high parameters that creates a lot of smoke, then you need a high flow and a lot more pressure going into your torch to do an effective capture of the smoke. For example, if you're welding 045 flux core at say 240 amps, you would need at least 50 inches of static pressure entering the torch to perform a fair smoke extraction. Now, if you're welding at 350 amp with super high parameters, then you need to have a system that's able to create all the way up to 80 or 90 inches of static pressure to create the flow effective enough to capture your smoke. What if you don't see a proper static pressure reading on your system? You're reading the vacuum right at the torch. There's a network that gives you the vacuum, so you can go step by step all the way up to the source of the vacuum. You bring the gauge closer to the vacuum and you figure out where the issue is. One of the main factors reducing the vacuum static pressure is the actual flexible hose that you use before the gun. If your static reading is not high enough, you can always look at using a bigger flex hose or a shorter flex hose. If you have a flexible hose that has a small diameter, like an inch and a half, and that you have to run this hose for like 15 or 25 foot, you may benefit by increasing the diameter of the hose in order to reduce the loss that the flexible hose is creating. If the hose between your torch and the system is not the issue, then you may have to look at other factors that are reducing the static pressure or the flow. One of the major causes of pressure drop is an actual filter that's not clean. So if the filter is filled with dust and particles, it's not letting the air go through and it's creating a big pressure drop. Another thing that you have to look for are leaks. Leaks are creating pressure drops and flow loss. So in order to optimize your flow and pressure, you want to make sure that all the way from the torch to the vacuum system, there are no leaks. You need to seal them and make sure you lose no vacuum or no air. Once you've looked at the basic components of your system, your hoses have no leaks, your filters are clean, the hose's size or length have been modified or corrected, and you're still not getting the result you want, then it may be the vacuum system in itself that needs to be modified. The vacuum you require is affected by the welding position. If you're welding in a flat position or in a corner joint, you don't need as much vacuum as if you are welding vertical or overhead. Hopefully this video gave you enough information on how to assess your vacuum system in order to achieve the best smoke extraction result you're looking for. If you want to go more in depth with testing your smoke extraction system, you can find an article on the ABI blog. Thanks for watching. This is Etienne Blouin for ABICOR BINZEL. Have a good day.